All right. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. This is Landon Strange here. And for the first time, I'm going to do something called Late Night Sneaker Chats. And right now, as I'm looking at them on the monitor, I see a pair of... Before I discuss the shoes, so what we're doing tonight, something new, something different, something that we can enjoy as a community of sneakerheads, and we're just sneakerheads. I just had to find the right lens, so excuse the mess and everything, we're just all over the place, but I wanted to try something different. And so, for the first time, doing something not live, but something that we can talk about is basically, you know, talking about sneakers from a first pair of shoes I have up here to start off the late night sneaker chat is the Chris Paul Air Jordan Players Edition 2015. And all I can say is this. I mean, honestly, Air Jordan 11 is cool. And honestly, it's the inside, the same color as the book itself that I really am going to go through. The segment or part of the show and is to see what kind of shoes do we have, not only routine sneakers can enjoy, something that we can appreciate, especially since it's nothing but hype these cultures, it's just really long of this, and they don't have an appreciation for the shoe. And even the kids nowadays who get into sneakers don't have a real appreciation for the shoe. They just rather serve the shoe. Father behind the hype train, and so this is really for real genius and great. Now, I'm talking about 2015 was a great year for sneakers. The early 2010 to 2016 was the greatest time for sneakers, just like the whole problem that has happened. But I'm glad these are very exclusive, and that's the other thing. Yes, Chris Paul's. He's still a Jordan. I don't want to get wrong with that information. But there are some shoes that didn't get a general release. I'm kind of glad that these did. Only because of the fact that we already have that Tiffany Cole shoe. I got a pair of black and dark ones myself. And everything in this shoe, from the top, the leather, the white bottom, the 11th. I'm not a big 11th person. To pull up the next shoe, and like I said, it's not just going to be like Nikes and Jordans and whatnot. This is more or less like jumping towards all different brands. I want to be fair to all brands, so like I said, I'd rather just pull them up when I see them on Twitter and then just go from there and see what y'all think about them. Like I said, I'm not doing this live, so this gives me a chance to, you know, be easy, relax, take a break. And enjoy the conversation. But the next pair of shoes I'm about to pull up is a pair of New Balances. Six Phantom, New Spruce, and Timberline. I mean, I don't mind that Timberline. Like, that, it's a lighter shade of that. But low key, just looking at this shoe itself. Like, New Balances this one is, this shit for me is, I don't know about y'all, I'm glad they changed the name from Dread to this next shoe. Let's fix that. Let's fix the sizing of the screen, shall we? All right. All I need is just one. I just need to see. I need to see both of y'all. Let's see if I can fix that. Well, I'll take it for what it is. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm glad they changed the name from Red for these. You know, for those who know Jordan 6s truly came out with infrared, carmine. You know, those colorways have significance. And I hope this is a mock-up. They're called Fire Red. And even then, the Fire Red colorway is more or less of a white red. This is the March 1st episode, by the way. And I'll probably do another one March 2nd. But right now, March 1st is going on. I just got a lot of stream for those who are watching. And so I told my friends, as tired as these shoes, how disappointing. Like, I mean, the only thing that's different from them in infrared is literally the gray. Like, the gray next to the bubble. Like, the white, that gray. I mean, if you want to call it fire red, but it's that, I mean, to each his own. Like, this is a 2 out of 5, in my opinion. Like, y'all can come for me in the comments below, but no, no, no. I feel like this is a 2. Maybe a 2.5. To each his own. Alright. Let's see. Now, I already did. Let's see if I can find something else that the people would like to talk about. Ooh. I think this might be every Hypebeast dunk. Every Hypebeast favorite dunk this year. Take it with a grain of salt. I feel like this might be the one for them. But low key, well, high key, these Safari / Olympic SB lows. Plain, simple, cannot complain. Nice shoe, no problem. Depending on when that submitted comes out, might be a hit, might be a miss. But low key, I mean, Safari, you never go wrong with a Safari colorway. But the simple fact is that you're doing a Safari colorway. A new lazy is just to make the shoe, pop, like the insole. Like the top part of the shoe itself, it's like a burnt print. Then you got the print. Nike check swooshes in between the print and the regular cut regularly. Mid-air in the shoe. And it looks nice. That blue makes it pop much more particular to the style of the shoe. And it's something different that I think we can more or less appreciate the shoe for what it is than just making the shoe out for, you know, something that could be retail for a long period of time, or do like the Powerpuff Girls, get high and then just add a consistent point, and that's something that is very appreciative if they can stand that point of marketplace. Now, we're going back to New Balance, and now I'm not gonna lie, and I'm gonna pull up the next shoe. Let's see if we can get it going. about these on Friday Night BS before. Hell of a good shoe. No complaints there. I'm a Bronson fan, musically. And his New Balances have been pretty heat. I've been pretty mad I slept on the last, the pairs that came out last year. But Rosewater itself, for the 1906 R, honestly and truthfully, and it's not even because it's Bronson, I just like the mix of the orange and purple, like, that's more of a spring, maybe a spring, pushing spring, but light, like spring is a mix of something like, this is going to be a great running shoe itself, but I feel like this could honestly get more, maybe 375, because the other colorway is better. It's just, the only thing that upsets the balance of the shoe, maybe that's just me. Y'all can leave a comment below, you know what y'all think, is green lace. Like, I see the green in the midst of the background, you know, with the laces. Hopefully you have another pair of laces that will come with these. Like, shoes are, don't get me wrong, shoes are pretty solid. Solid shoe, no question about it. But, cute. But, in the long run, I feel like there's more to do with this shoe. I mean, respect Bronson, respect the art. No questions asked. You know, I'm gonna at least, you know, show love where love is shown. I just wish, I wanna know if there's more laces. Like, even with that light purple closer to the tip of the shoe, honestly, I feel that you can make it work. I mean, that green laces, I feel like you can still make them work. It's just, I don't know. I like them, but the laces are just the thing that just put me off. Now, jump back to Jordan. Version of the video, it'll have all the shoes, you know, up there, ready to go, you know, have the tag and everything like that. It'll be an edited version, and it'll be a raw version of the video, of course. But the Armand Meunier Air Jordan 3 OG Special Edition Black that released July 18th. My only question, in all honesty, is why are you dropping this shoe the same year that the Black Cats are supposed to be? The Black Cats have history. No questions asked. I'm not taking that away from anyone or anybody or anything. Cats and these is just the bottom for the bubble gum, and then you could just say without itself that you could say a darker black cement, but I feel like that's more of a harder leather than anything. I mean, I'm cool with it. I'm genuinely cool with the shoe, but when it comes to like the argument Black Cats, and I don't remember if they did push back to Black Cats or not, but I'm genuinely 50-50 on these. And after meeting the creator of Social Status, I'm on the air on Valentine's Day for a special event that he had traveling to the city, and especially stopping in Houston on Valentine's Day. Don't get me wrong, the man is a genius. The man actually inspires me. Don't know about the shoes. I just don't know how I feel about it. That's me personally. I think y'all would get into higher rating, but me personally, I sit them at a three, and it's only because of the timing of the shoe.
We are going to a throwback. We are going to a throwback, ladies and gentlemen. We are going to a throwback now. We're going to drop off another shoe and throwback to the throwback conversation. I've already given y'all 20 minutes of a sneaker show. I'm at least trying something different, you know, to catch people to join. If you like what you're seeing, if you like the conversation, if you go live, let me know. I'm still testing this out. I didn't go live for personal, so I'm just going to test out the feeling and the setup. While we are talking about shoes, a throwback for people, 2020, which was such a long time ago, was the Kobe 5 Ray PEs. If they brought these back out, I think the market would be a little more... it wouldn't be stagnant. And the reason I say it wouldn't be standing when it comes to these personally is because they're bringing out new ideas with Kobe's for the products. And the blue, that cream, that gold, and like the webbing around the Nike Tech, the stitching, which is like a bunch of spider webs within the Nike Tech. Like, everything about this shoe represents a piece of art, in my opinion, and I might be wrong, you know, I'm not the best, but at least when it comes to, like, doing genuine sneakers, we're talking about shoes that's come out in the past from the player edition. I mean, I can't rate the shoe. I would like to know what y'all think about these. Please leave a comment below, or at least a rating. Y'all opinion, what y'all like about these. What is it? Like I said, even with this version, I'm gonna do an edited version with the names of the shoes and all that stuff. But like I said, I'm just working this out in the future. All right, let's see what else we got. We're still with the clothing. I think I found every hype beast favorite shoes for this year. And you can correct me if I'm wrong, but I think I found the shoe for the hype beast. Every hype beast is going to find a way to make this shoe great or have fun. My opinion is up to you to decide. I'm not the biggest one. I'm not complaining either way, but I feel like and I'm talking about this in a dunk point of view, and we're not in the future. You know what I mean? Because when it comes to Jordans, I already know what shoes are going to be oversold, overtaxed for no fucking reason. Alright, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. I feel like, in my opinion, say what you want. If the future off-white dunks already is still high as hell for the future, everybody in their mind will find a way to make it even higher. I feel like the shoe itself is nice. Is it Nike SB Paris work? Or Tiffy, OG Tiffy work? But I see where they're going. I like the idea. I like the design. The tie-dye is nice. No problem with either. Ooh, I do apologize. Like I said, I'm tired. Like I said, this is the test
episode.
But that's neither here nor there. Needless to say, back to the conversation at hand. When it comes to these, I want these to be for everyone, but let's be real. The Hypebeast already got back doors to them. You know, when there's a back door to the shoe market, the shoe is already ruined. Like, you can't even enjoy the sneaker anymore because most people back door, they're going to overtax it. And that's really what we're doing in the market. But, alrighty, let's see what else we got. Let's try a different shoe. I'm gonna save some of these that I've seen right now that are, you know, that could be conversation pieces for later. But right now, I'd rather pick a different brand just to see. Alright, I think I got something for you.
Saw them, they didn't remind me of the Drew Futures in a 12-4.
for like the red envelope sealed tongue and the icy white 12 bottoms. A1. But that gray knitted pattern throughout the shoe. I'm gonna be honest with you. If they would have did something different with the gray pattern instead, I would have rated the shoe higher, in my opinion. 5. Y'all might give it a 3.5, but me personally, in my heart, and y'all can correct me if I'm wrong, leave a comment below. Tell me what I'm wrong. Don't y'all be adding comments on my shoes. Them personally. Still a decent shoe, don't get me wrong. Still decent. You know, I'm not complaining. But overall, it could be better. Alright, let's see what else we got. Alright. I know y'all gonna want me to do a pair of shoes for this person, and to each his own. Like I said, I knew this person at the time, and I think y'all are some of his biggest fans, so we're gonna just have to talk about it at this point, and it's okay. I'm okay with that. Now, ladies and gentlemen, these are the Travis Scott Air Jordan Low Black Olive, which will release September 12, 2024. And then you have the Travis Scott Air Jordan Regular Olive, which will release spring 2025. And they both go for 150. That does not mean that they will stay 150. These are Jordan 1 Lows, but they are collaborative. That means they're going to shoot up between 500 and 1,000. How late? Let's just be real. Black Olive, no complaint. You know it's coming out in September. That's going to be a great fall shoe. It just reminds me too much of the Lows. I hate to be the one to say it, but call me out on it. I don't care. I mean, the White Olive, I honestly prefer the White. Let me say this. The Black Olive leather is the same leather that is on the mochas. But the White Olive, I mean, that reminds me of a casual golf shoe. I will give the top pair 3.5, but I will give that bottom pair a 3.75. Or at least the top pair 3.25. Yeah, 3.25 for the top pair, 3.75 for the bottom pair. The white pair, honestly, that material, like from the photo, it looked like it's going to breathe. So it might loosen up. It might give you some real creasing. But that's just my opinion. Leave a comment below if you think you can get a better rating on it. Oh, yes. Oh, there we go. Let me see. And we did a 30-minute episode. Like, that's just wild in itself. We gonna keep going, you know. I like making content like this for Sneakers and Stogies, just so that way when we actually do get back to doing what we do best, I'm gonna keep it rolling. Like I said, this is the first episode. It's not the last. We're gonna keep this going as many episodes as we can and make it move in many ways as we can with the show. And so we're gonna stick with another Jordan shoe before we switch shoes. I was wondering about this shoe myself, and I pray this is just a mock-up or an idea of the shoe. Let's pull this up now. This is not the actual collaborative version, but this is just a version of the shoe itself. And we have the
special edition. If this is the four without the back heel, I have to see this first. I want to know what y'all think about these right here. Honestly, let me know what y'all think about these, because it's an AJ. They're calling it an Air Jordan 4. And I'm not a fourth person, so I can't put my own pieces in this argument. But for the fans of Air Jordan 4, y'all might want to talk to me about these, because them's not the ones, them the two. They really, the fours are what they call. Alright, let's keep going. Y'all gonna hate, y'all already gonna flag my channel. Y'all already gonna cancel this show before you get a chance to grow. That's cool. I accept it for what it is. This the raw, so I'm about to edit it tonight anyway, so I'm about to edit the raw of this song. How fun is that? Probably 2 posts for the price of one. Let me fix this though. These are the AJ 38 Low Sunshine. If you ever wanted a glass of OJ in the morning and you see these shoes, well, that's between you and your masters. But honestly and truthfully, sorry, I had to handle that. Honestly and truthfully, I don't do shoes on Jordan besides the original 15, 18, 20, and 21, 22, 23. Yeah, let's get that out of the way. I know these are pure basketball shoes. Got it. If your team jersey color is not either red, yellow, or orange, or it's not a bright color, I respect the sneaker as a hooping shoe, but that's it. That's it. That's all I can say. That is the nicest comment I can say. And I'm really holding back. But
that's not a good order.
Let's see what else we can find, because these are not, I wouldn't even say an abomination. Oh my god. Wow. I'm about to take y'all back into the past. I ain't gonna lie. I've had these, and I wore them down to the nut. I love them ever since. And I did a closet clean out recently, and I'm just sad I had to take these. But ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we take you back to the past, we take you back to class, we take you to 2007 with the black metallic Air Jordan 5. Say what you want about 5s and how older 5s don't last long. I gotta be here now. You gotta wear your 5 in rotation. I got some 5s from the 13 era that had last. 2011 worn out. But them, black metallic, I still have a love and appreciation for black metallic, especially if it's the Nike era on the back. I know these didn't have it. If I'm not mistaken, these did not have it. But I know for a fact that I appreciate them still to this day. Now, we gonna run to Adidas for a reason. Adidas have had his moments. And I mean he might be, from all the reviews and all the positive feedback I've been seeing, might be Adidas' best basketball shoe for the first time in a while. And I'm saying like Stewie, quiet. Yeah, I'm saying like Stewie, quiet. But I am not a hooper. No stretch of the imagination. But I do love good, comfortable sneakers, and I love great sneakers, and honestly, just seeing these, not even in person, but in videos and everything like that, just the texture and everything behind it, I genuinely like these AEs. Just the shoe itself, let me rephrase it, I like the AE shoe itself. These colorways are nice, don't get me wrong, but the AE shoe itself, chef's kiss. Chef's fucking kiss. No questions asked. Alright, let's continue down the list and see what else we have to add to this. I'm literally about to give you like a great friend for the show, so I hopefully y'all do appreciate that. I'm actually trying something new, trying to make more consistent stuff, especially for the channel, but also getting back to doing live stuff as well. I'm really over this. Complaining about them. Like, they even got, like the bottom of the shoe itself is even worn on its own. Like, it's a grungy look. It's like a real chill, grungy look shoe. So, that's something to really appreciate. Now, like I said, later throughout this series, I'm going to go through this book and actually enjoy. This was a great birthday gift, you know. Shout out to Ricky and Jermaine for, they've been on the show, of course, but shout out to them. They gave me this birthday gift, and I really do appreciate it. So, because of that, I am going to go through some of this book and actually enjoy the intensity of the festival. Someone has missed it, you know. Needless to say, no complaints there. Alright. We're going to go to another Jordan real quick. Everybody is really just gonna call these the one-man OVOs. And that's their prerogative, you know? Not even tier 2 version. There's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with a tier 2 shoe. Okay. Alright. I'm about to do something I'm going to regret the nature. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we give you KD's Sneakers. They've already just came out. The Serpent has made sure that we can all appreciate this shoe. I'm not saying it's a hot shoe. It's cold at the bottom, like it's red, the red and the black is like it's going through your soul. It's like, it tells a story of itself. If I have an opinion about it, I have my own opinion about it. I'm not going to be my opinion to construct from the shit itself. But needless to say, it's still a solid shoe. No questions asked. Like, I'm not complaining. Not mad. It's a solid shoe. Oh, hold on. I know what I need to do now. I knew I was forgetting something in my heart. We still got 15 minutes of show time, and that means I gotta get on somebody's ass real quick. Hold on. Hold on. I was waiting to get on somebody's ass, but it just hit me. We talking basketball shoes. Let me see if I can find them real quick. Because, lo and behold, there are a pair of shoes that somebody need their ass with. Like I said, I'm tired. I do appreciate y'all checking out this section of the show. Here we go. Here we fucking go. Ladies and gentlemen, the next three shoes might be how I end the show. They might be how I end the show, but if I feel like I need to end it off on a better note, I will. We need to talk about this. We. Alright, we're gonna start off with the first one. Off-White debuts the Baller basketball shoe. The shoe has the feature of actual basketball leather. What in the starberry hell do y'all think y'all do with this extra glitter? Rhinestone and shoe. What in the dada's supreme? If I see somebody whooping in these shoes and they don't get 30 points in them, why the fuck did you spend all them? I don't know if I have anything genuinely nice to say about this shoe. And I'm really trying my hardest. But this shit is hard. Can someone in the comments go around explain to me what the hell is going on with this shoe? But it's not just this one. No. You chose to make another pair. Now, I'm not a fashion designer by any means of necessary. What in the hell is this? What
in the Incredible Hulk. What is this? What is the big green or purple giant doing with these? What you doing, D? You better not have a size. I don't wear a size 13. So a size 13 up, you gonna look like you have big ass Hulk feet. You might as well just say you made expensive Hulk shoes for hooping. Like, what the fuck are these? But there's more. There's one more. There's one fucking more. Excuse my language, but there's one more. All right. At least this is a shoe featured from an actual basketball made by Off-White. Yeah, no, I have to end this on a positive note. I can't end this on a negative note. I can't. Because these, why? Who hurt y'all? What the fuck y'all? Who blackmailing y'all to make these shoes, man? Take these back. Take them motherfucking back. Don't bring them at the house. You keep your Off-White strawberries at home. You got it? I changed shoes a little bit early, and that's fine. I couldn't just live with that. Couldn't do it. Oh, this photo is horrible. The photo is horrible, but the A6 is nice. The photo sizing is horrible, but the A6 are nice. Like, I actually like these A6. A6 is slowly coming back, slowly but surely. But the shoe itself is nice. I have nothing bad to say about the A6. Excuse me. Nothing bad. Not like the last shoe. Now that shoe was a piece of shit. But if this photo comes out right, maybe y'all might say, if you think the last shoe happened that before this was a piece of shit, then why are you giving these a compliment? And I'm like, you are rightfully just the same as you feel about these shoes. And I'll say this. I'll go down on this end to the Off-White shoe. But if somebody really make a pair of New Balance loafers, and this is the first color instead of a black or a white, but it's green, if it's under two, I might actually get a pair of New Balance loafers. I'll probably down it. This will probably be the hill I die. This is the most positive note that I can make. Like, I would probably down this one. Is the hill I choose. This would be the hill I choose to die. This one. But, you know, hey, maybe I'm in the wrong. You know, for thinking out of pocket with these. But, honestly, truthfully, I would get a pair. Just to be nice, which is a rarity for me, people who don't really know how that shit is, no complaint about it. But I'm going to do this because I'm trying to do better in 2024 as a person. But LeBron actually has some nice shoes. These LeBrons are actually nice. The Liverpool FC Nike LeBron Next Gen Amped. Say what you want about LeBron's new baseballs. Say what you want about LeBron's shoes. Say what you want about him being the GOAT or him not being the GOAT. That's fine. This shoe, solid. No complaints. No issues. Not a singular issue. Not a singular complaint. Not a singular problem. No fault and no fight with this shoe. And if you this one. You must like that blue. That look, the blue, the black, that green. That's all on y'all. But the last shoe I'm going to do for today. Okay, you know, just to do something a little different. I'm going to do the Kyrie Irving shoe that already has a weight. And excuse me if I say the brand name wrong. I do apologize. But the Kyrie Irving, I need the Kyrie 1s. I don't know. Maybe it's just me. Maybe y'all might find a way to rock them. Maybe y'all may like them or not. That's on y'all's decision. Honestly and truthfully, if this is a performance shoe, all for Kyrie shoe. You know, he said some things that's between him and what he has to deal with. That's on him. As a shoe itself, I have nothing bad to say about it. Different, like it's something different, something to spice up the world, you know. It already has like more than 11,000 people waiting on this shoe already, and it dropped March 6th. Like, come on now. I'm not the, you know, most extra person out there, but when it comes to like inside, you know, shoe is the foundation. What am I saying? Am I wrong about this? Like, I have nothing. About him not doing anything. I'm just speaking from a genuine point of view, like the shoe actually solid. And so I'm gonna leave a pair of shoes on here, and this is for the next episode. I am not a person of hopefully, if you like comment, if you like what you saw, if you like what I'm producing, if you want to leave your own shoe and actually leave a review on it, leave a comment below, like, comment, follow, subscribe, all of that, you know, help produce the YouTube algorithm for Sneakers and Stogies. And so, I'm going to get a shoe, I'm going to pull up a shoe in just a second, give me a second. Like I said, y'all getting the raw video, and then I'm about to redo the video again. So, when I say I'm really trying with this, but I'm about to leave the shoe. And I want y'all to leave me y'all honest opinion about the shoe. Leave it in the comments. You can message me on Twitter and all that stuff. But I want y'all to leave me an honest opinion with this shoe. And y'all probably already seen it on Twitter. But y'all let me know what y'all think of this shoe. Give me 1 second. I'm going to get it for y'all. I just had it in my Boston. God damn it. Last shoe tonight, like I said, we're just talking sneakers at this point. That's probably gonna be the cover for this name. Talking sneakers episode 1. Late night sneaker talks. Talking sneakers. Here we go. This is the last shoe of the night. Best comment
issue will be read on an episode, the next upcoming episodes. Once the reviews and everybody else start watching it, I'll wait on it. But I want to know y'all honest opinion about the issue. The best comment